Morning to all of you. By the grace of great God, great mind at the start. Our today topic is reflection and transmission on a string at the discontinuity. Okay. See, this is a part of string. This is a string, and T is a constant tension along the string. This is the boundary. Boundary is the two media. This is medium one. This is medium 2. I want to transfer a signal from this part to the this part. Okay. Let us say this here in the medium 1, the wave is called incident wave, and when it will get reflected back, it is called reflected wave, and some part of it will be transmitted, and that part is called a transmitted wave. And rho 1 and rho 2 are the linear densities, mass per unit length. Rho 1 and rho 2 are called linear densities for medium 1 and medium 2. Okay. What is rho? Rho is called density. Mass per unit length of the string. Mass per unit length of the string. And what is B is equal to C? B is equal to D by rho. What is this? This is the velocity of transverse wave. This is the velocity of a transverse wave of a string. See, this is very beautiful article. All the things are connected. Okay. When we do it, we will definitely get into it. And what is this? Z is called a characteristic impedance. It is called a characteristic impedance that is equal to rho into V. V is velocity. Okay. So for the medium 1, velocity is different. And for the medium 2, velocity is different. So but eventually same, because the string is same. So V1 is equal to T by rho 1, square root of T by rho 1, and V2 is equal to T by square root of T by rho 2. Here V1 and V2 are the range velocities. Just try to understand. And we are doing it for the at the boundaries at x is equal to 0. This is the positive x axis. This is the negative x axis. Okay, are you getting this? It's quite easy. I think we have already done for the impedance matching also. Same thing. See, when the incident wave will get strike to this boundary of this medium, what will happen? Some part of it will get reflected back in the medium, and some part of the wave will get transmitted in the second medium. The part which will get reflected back in the medium 1 is called reflected wave. And this pass, see, incident wave is traveling along the positive x direction, and the reflected wave is traveling along the negative x direction. And the transmitted wave is traveling along the positive x direction. Are you getting this? Incident wave is traveling along the positive x direction. Reflected wave is traveling along the negative x direction, and transmitted wave is traveling along the positive x direction. Now I will write the displacement of this incident wave. What is the general equation for the displacement? Y is equal to A into e to the power iota omega t minus k. This is the general equation. This is the general equation for the displacement of any wave. Okay? For the incident wave, it will become, let us say A1 is, this is for the medium 1, this is become characteristic impedance become Z1, and for the medium 2, it will become Z2. Okay? And for the medium 1, it will become K1, and for the medium, this will become a K2. Where K1 and K2 are called the propagation constant, And value of k is equal to 2 pi by this is the general, this is the general expression, k is equal to 2 pi by lambda. End of. Now I will play a trick here. Yes, what I will do, k is equal to 2 pi nu frequency. I will multiply by frequency, divide by frequency. Any difference?
No.
Frequency different frequency. What is 2 pi nu? 2 pi nu is called omega.
Omega.
2 pi nu is called omega. Because omega is equal to 2 pi by t. Okay. Or 2 pi nu. So I can write here k is equal to 2 omega by, what is this? Frequency to wavelength. That is called the velocity. See, for a photon, c is equal to for the photon c is equal to nu lambda, but here we are not taking a photon, so c becomes v, v is equal to nu to lambda. What is nu? Frequency. What is lambda? So I can write k is equal to omega by and out. End out, friends. Let's go on. I think it's quite easy. I think we are just playing with the figures. Nothing more than that. We are just playing with the figures. Yes. Which one?
This is a string.
Yes, string. Kada. String. This is a string. Thread. You can take a thread. Okay. This is a thread. And we want to transfer the weight from this part to this part, and we will see how the things are going to happen. Okay. And now, can you write the displacement from the incident weight from this equation? For the incident weight, y becomes for incident weight. Y becomes y1. A becomes A1. Let us say, what is A? Amplitude. A is called amplitude. And for the first part, A becomes A1. Integration of iota omega t minus t1x. End out, friends. It's quite easy. We are just playing with the figures. Okay, I think we have done it for the number of times. Second, for the reflected wave, you can do by yourself. For the reflected wave. For the reflected wave, let us say this is y I. Can I write y I instead of 1? I means incident. I means incident. For reflected wave, Chitika, what for reflected wave? This equation becomes y becomes y r. Y becomes y r. And A becomes reflected amplitude A2. Let us say this A2. Shabash, good. A2 e raised to power iota. See, it is traveling along the positive x direction. And this is traveling along the negative direction, x direction. So, it becomes for iota omega t. This becomes minus of t1. Minus plus. That becomes plus t1. And out. This is now the positive x direction. This is now the negative x direction. Okay. See, minus plus. End out. Yes, correct. End out. Now third, for transmitted wave. What is the equation? This is the general equation. Y becomes yt, transmitted power. Yt is equal to amplitude becomes let us say it is v1. Book is taking it as a v1, so this is v1, this is v2. We can take any value. For the sake of simplicity, this is becomes A2. Hanji, e raised to power iota omega t minus A2x. End out. Because now it is traveling in the medium 2. For the medium 2, K2. K2 is the propagation constant. Okay. Okay. हाँ जी, y i is the incident displacement of the incident wave, a1 is the amplitude of the incident wave, b1 is the amplitude of the reflected wave, a2 is the amplitude of the transmitted wave, yt is the displacement of the transmitted wave, yr is the displacement of the reflected wave. End out. Now apply boundary conditions. See, At x is equal to 0, this yi plus yr must be equal to the yt. Displacement of incident plus reflected must be equal to the transmitted displacement of the transmitted wave at x is equal to 0. So put that. Apply first boundary condition. Apply first boundary condition. Apply. Tell me what is the answer. Apply and adding boundary condition. With the right hand, boundary condition. And first boundary condition is yi plus yr is equal to yt at t at x is equal to 0. At x is equal to 0. I mean to say displacement of incident wave plus displacement of reflected wave must be equal to the displacement of the transmitted wave at this boundary. At this point. Okay. Now use x is equal to 0. Put x is equal to 0. What I am getting? So what is yi? A1 e to the power iota omega t minus k1 into 0. Number 2. Okay. Plus v1 e to the power iota omega t plus k2 to 0 and that is equal to this part yt a2 is for iota omega t minus k2 to 0. What I am getting? E to the power iota omega t common a1 plus b1 is equal to a2 into this will cancel, so I am getting A1 plus B1 is equal to A2. And out, A1 plus B1 is equal to A2. Let us say, this is 1, this is 2, this is 3, this is R, 4. And omega is equal to k is equal to 2 pi by lambda and that is equal to omega by v. We will use this equation. Let us say this equation number is 5. Okay. I am multiplying with the frequency. This is frequency. This becomes omega, this becomes velocity. And now, yes? Positive x direction and reflected part is traveling along the negative x direction. Similarly, transmitted wave is traveling along the positive x direction. And due to direction, this k1 value will be changed. If it is along the positive x direction, we will use minus k1. If it is along the negative x direction, we will use a plus k1. And for the transmitted wave, it is along the positive x direction, so that is a minus k2. Simple.
Okay. Yeah. So I have a question there on one note.
Which one?
If we check our incident wave, right? We have plus h t n.
On
which one?
It's just increasing incident to the direction. It's not having to change.
Oh.
Okay. So this is k1. This is a minus of k1. This is of our k2. That depends upon the direction in which wave is moving. Okay. So according to the direction, we are writing the displacement. This is also called the wave function. This is also called a wave function also. Okay. So now cross second boundary condition. The second boundary condition is the transverse force. The transverse force t dy by dx at x is equal to 0. Now apply the transfer force, T derivative is continuous across the boundary. Is continuous across the boundary. Okay, this first boundary condition is y incident plus y reflection is equal to yt at x is equal to 0. The second boundary condition is, what is dy upon dx? dy upon dx is called a slope. It means this slope is also continuous. Okay, there must not be any discontinuity at the boundary. If there is a discontinuity, then the signal will not transfer from this part to this part. Are you getting my point? There must not be any kind of discontinuity at the boundary. So derivative must be continuous. Okay. What does this mean? Derivative must be continuous at the boundary because the derivative gives us a slope. Okay. So apply this. So what is the condition becomes? It will become T d y for the incident wave plus for the reflected wave t d y r upon dx is equal to transmitted part t d y t upon dx. End out. And that is at x is equal to 0. Derivative, this is for the incident part. I will write, this is for the incident part, incident wave. This is for the reflected wave part. And this is for the transmitted part. I need to say the derivative must be continuous at the boundary. If the derivative will not be continuous, the slope will not continuous. If the slope will not continuous, what does this mean? There is discontinuity. And if there is discontinuity, it means signal will not transfer from this place to the another place, from medium one to the medium. Okay. For example, if you want to travel from this class to the another class, there must be a proper way. In the corridor. If the proper way will not be occurred in the corridor, what will happen? Are we able to cross that cross? No, we are not able to cross. It means that there is discontinuity, we are not supposed to allow. So that is why we are taking derivative. What is this? This is called a slope. See, slope. It's in the curve form, so we want a slope. This is a slope for the incident part, this is slope for the reflected part, and this is slope for the transmitted. समझ आ रहा है प्रॉब्लम? समझ आ रहा है? काफी खुशी तब बस ना आर गेटिंग दिस. नाउ प्लीज टेक द डेरिवेटिव ऑफ दिस. व्हाट इज वाई आई? ए इनटू ई रेस टू पावर आयोटा ओमेगा टी माइनस के वन एक्स. दिस वाई आई. टेक द डेरिवेटिव विद रिस्पेक्ट टू एक्स. व्हाट्स द आंसर? डी वाई आई अपॉन डी एक्स इज इक्वल टू ए ए वन इस बार आयोटा omega t minus k x into, what is the answer? minus iota k. Now can I write this? I think there is no use. Okay. Similarly calculate d y r upon dx and similarly calculate d y t upon dx. Can you give me the value? This will become a b1 into, what was yr? Yr is equal to b1 into e raised to power iota omega t plus k1 x. That will give me a e power iota omega t. Okay, plus v1x into iota v1. And similarly for the yt, This is equal to A2 into this power iota omega t minus A2 x into minus iota. And out. Which one?
So you passed it. How I see clear into five.
You are not getting this.
Equation 5.
Which one?
Equation 5.
Question 5.
The top
5
to the
right. This question number. This question you are not getting.
Yeah, I can see
the problem. Okay, see. K is equal to 2 pi by lambda. This is the general equation. K is called a propagation constant or it is called a B vector. I will multiply derivative by mu into mu. And out. Any difference? No. This mu will cancel with this mu. This 2 pi this is called a omega. It's called a omega. Upon. And the frequency to wavelength is called a velocity. Wave velocity. Now you see how I calculate difference, how I calculate derivative.
Yes,
okay. Now put x is equal to 0. Put x is equal to 0 also. Because derivative must be continuous at x is equal to 0. I calculate the derivative. Put x is equal to 0. What I am getting? This part will vanish.
Yes,
only part iota omega t will survive. Similarly, only iota omega t will survive. Similarly, part iota omega t will survive. First of all, I will write this. This will become b1 into e to the power iota omega t minus k1x into minus of iota k1 plus b1 into e to the power iota omega t plus k1x into iota k1. Okay, is equal to A2 into iota, A2 into minus of iota K2 into e to the power iota omega t minus A2. Put x is equal to 0. I'm getting minus A1 iota K1 e to the power iota omega t. Plus b1 into iota k1 iota omega t. Okay. Only this part will survive because
x minus.
Yes. And minus iota a2 k2 iota. Again, this e to the power iota omega t will cancel.
Cancel.
Yes, cancel. What I am getting minus b1 iota k1 plus b1 iota k1 minus iota a2 and out. Multiply by t also. T. Okay. T. Okay. Okay, and out. So I am getting minus iota will also cancel.
Yes, sir.
So I am getting minus t a1 to k1 plus t b1 to k1 is equal to minus a2 k2 into t. Okay. I will need this equation, remember, memorize this. For the time being, I am rubbing this, otherwise I will need this. I will write here, A1 plus B1 is equal to A2, that is equation number 4. It is simple mathematics, okay. Minus T, A1, K1. Now divide by B1. Sorry, what's the value of K1? K is equal to omega by b. This is 6. pi, and for k1 it becomes omega into v1, and for k2 it becomes a2 into omega by v2. And out. And out. Yes. Okay. So I will use here minus t a1 into omega by v1 plus t v1 omega by v1 is equal to minus a2 omega by v2 into okay. And t by v1 is called z1 mechanical equivalence. And t by v2 is called a z2. So this t by v1 will become z1. Okay.
Yes.
So
tension over velocity is
equal to impedance. Hmm?
Like what?
That's
that equation.
Which one?
Tension over velocity.
That is equal to z1. That is called impedance.
Okay.
Yes. Okay. That is the direct expression we are using. So I'm getting. See, this omega will also cancel. This omega will also cancel. So I'm getting minus of z1 into a1 plus 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 z1 into b1 is equal to minus of a2 into z2. Okay, and that will become a that is common a1 minus b1 is equal to a2 z2. Z1 into A1 minus B1 is correct. I am taking the minus sign common. This minus sign cancel with this minus sign.
Yes,
so what I am getting, Z1 A1 minus B1 is equal to A2 Z. So let us say this is question number 6. This is 7. This is 8. This is 9. Z1 A1 B1 minus A2 Z. Okay. Now let's solve this.
Minus A1.
Which one?
Nine. Yeah.
See this one. This t by v, this omega will cancel. I will write here minus t by v1 into a1 plus t by v1 into b1 is equal to minus of t by v2 into yes. You can write this equation. This becomes z1. This becomes z2. This becomes okay. You can say this is 7. This is 8. This is 9. And this is going to a 10. So we have used 8 and 9 in 7. We are using 8 and 9 in a 7. Using, here I will write, using 8 and 9 in 7, so I am getting this equation. Okay. Now divide, see, this is question number 4. This is question number 4, a1 minus, first of all I will define the reflection coefficient. Can I have this?
Yes, sir.
What is reflection coefficient?
Reflection
coefficient. Reflection. Reflection coefficient. R is equal to, it is a ratio of the amplitude of the reflected part to the incident part. Ratio of the amplitude of the reflected part. What is the amplitude of the reflected part? V1. V1.
V1
upon A. V1 upon A. V1 upon A1. And out. V1 upon A1. Yes. Now we have these two equations. Okay, divide 4 by 10. Divide 4 by 10. Divide 4 by 10. What I'm getting? What I'm getting? A1 plus B1 is equal to A2. A1 plus B1 by A1 minus B1 divided by A2 into 0. And out. And out. This will cancel. What I'm getting? I'm getting A1 by plus B1 divided by A1 minus B1 into Z1 by Z2. And out. Apply CPD. Apply CPD. Component of enter, dividend rule. Apply mathematical property component of. You know what is this rule? No? One time plus, one time minus. Let us say A plus by B is equal to 2 by 3 or 3 by 2. If I will apply the component and divisor rule, it will become A plus B divided by A minus B is equal to 3 plus 2 divided by 3 minus 2. This will become 5 by 2. Apply component and divisor rule. In short, it is called a CPD. It's called a CPD, component and divisor. Apply A1 plus B1 plus A1 minus B1 plus one time plus, second time minus A1 plus B. This will cancel. This will cancel. And this will become Z1 plus Z2 upon Z1 minus Z2. And out. You can take the example of this. Yes, you take it.
Apply 4. That's the
thing. Here?
Apply.
Component and divisor rule. We have applied component and divisor rule. One time plus, one time minus.
Commonality.
Okay, so what I'm getting? What I'm getting? 2A1. What I'm getting? 2A1. I think I'm joining the article. It's very interesting. 2a1 upon 2b1 is equal to z1 plus z2 upon z1 minus z2. Again, to the cancel. So I'm getting a1 upon b1 z1 plus z2 divided by z1. What I need? I need b1 by a1. So what I will do? I will do by invertendo, not inverse. This is called by invertendo. By inverse, again mathematical property. It will become V1 by A1 is equal to Z1 minus Z2 upon Z1 plus Z2, and that is equal to R. And R is nothing but it is called a reflection component. Yes, correct.
Yes.
This is very beautiful article, and it always usually asked by the examiner. Calculate the reflection coefficient. Yes. Yes. Full-fledged article. In 6 to 7 marks. Calculate R. Similarly, calculate T. What is T? How can you calculate T? T is the amplitude of the transmitted part to the incident part. What is transmitted part? A2 upon A1. A2 upon A1. T is equal to A2 upon A1. I want to calculate. Okay. First of all, please note this. How much time is left? Kita sana bada ke? 10 minutes ho jaya. Aur bada na. See, what is R? R is called a reflection coefficient. And it is a ratio of the reflected part to the incident part. Simply formula Z1 minus Z2 upon Z1 plus A. Now see, this is this A1 plus B1. What is T? T is called transmission coefficient. T is called a transmission coefficient. Okay. Care about this?
Yes, sir.
T is called transmission coefficient and T is equal to A into bound. Okay. So I have the equation A1 plus B1 is equal to A2. Now I want to eliminate B1. So what I will do, I will write B in terms of A. So that all the calculations will appear in the form of A1 and A2. So B1, A1 plus B1 is equal to A2. From equation 4. What is B1? And what was the equation for the that A1 minus B1 Z1? What was the equation? For the derivative equation, A1 minus B1 into Z1 is equal to A1 minus C1 is equal to A2 Z2. What is the number?
10.
What is this equation number? No. What is the last number? 10. 11. This is 12. No. So this is 12. Use 12 and 10. So what I'm getting? See, A1 minus, what is B1? Minus A2 plus A. And out. This will become minus and this will become a plus. Into Z1 is equal to A2 into Z2. That will come out 2A1 minus A2 into Z1 equal to A2 into Z2. So 2A1 Z1 is equal to A2 Z2 plus A2 Z1. This plus. So 2A1 Z1 is equal to Z2 is common. No, A2 is common. Z2 plus Z2. So what is A2 by A1? A2 by A1 is equal to A2 by A1 is equal to 2Z1 by Z2. So this is equal to, and this is equal to A2 by A1 is called T. T, that is equal to T. So T is equal to A2 by A1 divided by 2Z1 upon A2 plus. So this is the transmission. Very interesting. Okay, very interesting. Definitely question will be asked in the following exam. Calculate the reflection and transmission coefficient. Calculate the reflection and transmission coefficient for a spline. Okay. So what is R? It is simply to memorize Z1 minus Z2 divided by Z1 plus Z2, and it is 2Z1 upon Z2 plus Z2. Special case. What is R? R is equal to Z1 minus Z2 upon Z2 plus Z2. If Z2 is infinity, special case, if Z2 is infinity, what is R? R is Z1 minus Z2 upon Z2 plus Z2. Can I write like this? Z1 by Z2 minus 1 divided by Z2 by Z2 plus 1. Simply I divide Z2 by numerator and denominator. If Z2 is infinity, Z1 by infinity comes out to be a 0, something on infinity, 0. So that becomes a 0 minus 1, 0 plus 1, R into minus 1. Okay, R is equal to minus 1. This is called a reflection at denser medium. This is called a reflection at a denser medium. If the wave is striking at the denser medium, the wave is striking at the denser medium. Denser medium means more value of impedance. Denser medium means more value of impedance. More value of impedance means more Z2. More Z2. It means, what are this minus? Minus 1 means, if this is a denser medium, Z2 denser medium, if this wave will strike to this point at x is equal to 0, and when it will be reflected back, there is a phase change. There is a phase change of pi. There is a phase change of pi. So it will, we can say that there is a phase difference between the incident wave and the reflected wave. Okay, let us say this wave is sin omega t minus kx, and this wave will be omega t minus kx plus pi, plus pi, and sin 180 plus theta is minus of sin theta, minus of sin theta. So minus sin tells us the, minus sin tells us the, what does it tell? It tells us the, there is a phase change. There is a phase change of pi. Please write phase change of pi. Phase change of pi along reflected wave. There is a phase change of pi along the reflected. And now, similarly, if z1 is equal to 0, let us say z1 is equal to 0, what will happen? If z2 is 0. If z2 is 0, next case is if z2 is 0. Special case 2. If z2 is 0. Z2 is 0 means reflection at the rear medium. Reflection at the rear medium. Put z2 is equal to 0. So r is equal to z1 minus 0. Z2, Z1 minus 0, then it becomes a 1. So reflection comes out to be a 1. What are the space? There is no phase change of pi. There is no phase change of a
5.
And out. So I think that is all about it for the today's session. And out. What is the reflection coefficient? Ratio of the reflected part to the incident part. And what is transmission coefficient? Ratio of the amplitude part, sorry, ratio of the transmitted part to the incident part. Reflection coefficient means ratio of the reflected part to the incident part, and in transmission coefficient, ratio of the transmitted part to the incident part. In the denominator, incident part will be there. Okay, for the reflection, B1 by A1. And for the transmission, A2 by A1. What is A1? A2, amplitude of the transmitted wave. What is A1? Amplitude of the incident wave. And what is R? R is equal to B1 upon A1. What is B1? Amplitude of the reflected wave. What is A1? Reflected of the incident. So see, in the denominator of incident part will be there. In the R as well as in the T. Okay, simply you have to memorize. Now you can memorize, in the denominator A1 will be there. For example, if I forget how to do, see, R is equal to T is equal to, in the denominator incident part, A1, this is B1, this is B2. Easy to remember. So that is a trick how we can memorize the things. So thank you so much for being with us. Thank you for the session. This is very, very important as far as the exam is concerned. Thank you.